my homeboy from the Yak, yeah, Pontiac. Yeah. You just got done battling Saga.
Yes, and I had to go to work. He went to work. I'm not going to front.
Don't front.
He came with it. But you know that's always what I ask for every battle. I say, bring me your shit because I'm coming to kill you. If you don't want to die, I'm going to need you to rap. And he rapped. But, you know, I knew what I was going to do. I had everything planned. I say, he can give me, you know, he can give me the best two rounds he can give me, but I have something that he's not going to be able to rebuttal this round. And then once I hit him with this round, it's going to slight the edge. Everybody, oh, it's 1-1. You got me fucked. Okay, I got you, Mr. 1-1. Watch this. So, you know, but nah, it was all in fun. He brought some shit, and he been on a streak lately, so this ain't nothing
Real
short
talk.
Of what he been doing.
Real
this ain't
talk.
Nothing short of what he been doing. I salute that nigga. He scared me. No, he didn't scare me. I don't never lose composure, but he would have scared a lot of niggas. Like, that Saga was different. He was dangerous.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I salute that. I need all that wreck. Because I will kick your ass.
I tell you what people are saying in the building.
Nope.
Let me tell you what somebody's saying. They're making it debatable. So it's like 2-2 either way.
2-2 either way.
2-2 either way. You think it's going to change once the battle drops?
I know it will. I have probably one of the strongest on-camera effects. A lot of people, you know, oh, yeah, JC lost that, and they'll go back. And even if they say I won the battle,
right,
a round that they say I lost, they'll come back and be like, yeah, you just didn't lose that round. You said too much. Like,
I ain't going to lie.
So, you know.
I ain't gonna lie, I did miss most of the battle because I was doing other interviews, but I came in the third, and y'all was going to town on the religion category, like, yo God versus my God. So,
yes. My whole round was, I was pulling Saga on my side and saying, bro, it's our God versus their God. And when I say their, I mean the people who introduced you to Christianity, which
right,
we all know who did that.
True.
Whip, whip. So that's why, you know, I kind of broke it down like, hey, this is not for us. We believe in God too. And if you go back to where we came from in Africa, we was naturally spiritual. So
True.
Even before, you know, all the slave, that's why I told them also, learn who you were before the slave ships. You go to school, that's where they start your history at. Like, that's where we was born on fucking slave. Like, what happened before this? So that's what I be studying. That's what I studied, and it just so happens to contradict Christianity.
Right.
So it was an angle that kind of set itself up, and I mean Christianity is not something that has flaws. It's a piece of shit.
Mm.
Like, it's not something that has flaws. It's a piece of shit.
The
problem with the Bible is they use it for religion, and I said that. You can't even find the word religion in the Bible. So
you did say that in your third.
Yeah, so
that.
That's the problem. Mm-hmm. So they all use the Bible for religion, but you can't. And that's why you get all this bullshit, doctrine that they use and all. That's where it come from. It come from the people saying you're not allowed to read. By the way, look at this. This is what this means. Don't think for yourself. This is what it really like. So we were told how to think. We were told how to talk. We were told how to, all right, Saga, I'm going to strip everything you've ever learned from your church, and then we can read the Bible. And you'll get a whole different book. You get a whole different book out of there. It's a black book. It's a black history book.
For sure. So October about to be next week. And by the time this battle and this interview drop, it's going to be October probably.
I'm going to be kicking Shug ass all over the stage in Philly.
Let's talk about it. So you got locked down because you just got done battling Saga. Shout out to Saga. He did his thing. So now you got Philly. You got Shug. Locked down. What you going to do?
Listen, I say this all the time when I got back-to-back battles. If Shug was here tonight, we could battle after the last battle.
Ooh, talk.
I have all this shit ready. I have it all ready. Like, people be like, oh, JC battling this way. Ain't no way he gonna be able to come up with enough shit for me. It's already there. I already got it all. When you niggas get booked, I pin it down and it's over. I move that shit to the side. Oh, you want me to battle such and such? Bring it here. Pin it, push it to the side. Oh, you want me to battle such and such? Bring it here. Pin it, push it to the side. Now I got three locked. whichever one comes first is the first one I get ready for.
Okay.
That one's done, I get next. That one's next. That one, next. They be like, man, I know he ain't write this. Nah, I mean, I'm just serious.
Are you, because I know a lot of fans have been saying on Twitter that, you know, Suge gets a little physical in his battles. Are you worried about, I know what you're about to say, but for the fans who don't really know you or pay attention to you when it comes to physicality or people doing the most in battles, are you worried about any of that?
Nah, I'm not. It really don't mean nothing.
Right.
I mean, we saw him do it to Rum, and it didn't go that well.
Right.
You know, he lost that battle. So just being, and I heard he lost to Jack Boy Maine, which, you know, not saying Jack is bad, but at this point, where he's messing up all his battles and all this shit, to be
honest,
the one
right.
that he loses to,
like, right?
All right.
Okay.
But you about to kick my ass just because you can get on stage and do that? No.
Pocket tap.
Not gonna work. You got good moments. It'll happen. But my moment is from the beginning of my first round to the end of my third.
Okay.
So he can have little moments in between, but like my shit, like I said, from the first line to the very last line, I had the whole room on fire. So like, if your moment ain't gonna be crazier than that, then you might as well just save it. Don't touch my pockets. I'm gonna do the battle with my pockets out. No money, I'm gonna do the battle, pull my pockets out. Don't play.
And you know, the year is almost over, so we about to get into, you know, champion of the year talk. And I see everybody and everybody talking about, you know, you should definitely be in consideration of champion of the year. How are your thoughts about that?
Well,
you feel like you should be champion of the year?
They see the work. I truly don't care. But I will say this. They see the work. The frequency, my G, the frequency of the battles, the quality of the battles, and the distance between the battles is something that hasn't been done before, especially on that level and on that stage. So to do that, they look at that and go, all right, that's somebody that he's doing something ain't nobody else done. It's one thing to just have battles to do back to back to back,
right.
But to have them at that level, nobody's done that. So I want to see, you know, whoever's champion of the year, you got to do something crazier than that. I don't think you can top that unless you do it 3 or 4 times in a day or some shit.
Well, speaking of Suge, who you about to battle, you know, he said he feel like he should be champion of the year because he's been battling a lot of top tier, a lot of big names. But other people are saying that, you know, it's about quality over quantity.
Well, exactly. Well, MSC, but then when you got somebody that has quality and quantity, you can't put too many people over that. You got somebody that might have quality, but they don't battle enough. Somebody that might have quantity, but ain't no quality in it. I will bring you all of that shit every time. So it's like, if that's the criteria, nah, it's not even close. You might as well hand me that shit now. We don't need no more battles. We don't need the rest of the year. Just hand me the belt and send that shit now. If that's what we judging off of, nobody's doing it at this rate at all. So that's not.
Well, a lot of people picked you as favorite to win last year. If you don't win this year, like, I know a lot of your fans are going to be like, well, what the hell do you got to do to win champion of the fucking year at this point?
And you know what? I think they acting like that because the illusion that I'm going for it is out there. When they see these mini battles and this frequent and this level of work, they go, well, damn, he must be trying to get champion of the year. Mm-hmm. That's not in my thoughts.
That's what a lot of people were saying last year.
That's not in my thoughts at all. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, like you remember, it's been 2 awards of champion of the year given. So,
right.
Y'all letting that define y'all careers already? Like, it's literally been 2 years. Like, have you existed before champion of the year? From them at the end of the year, I'm gonna still be solidified. This is no shade to Jay Black or nothing like that, because I think that's beautiful what he's doing.
But for people to
look at that and be like, okay, everything you're doing now as a person is for champion of the year. No. Hell no. To be honest, I'm just me. I'm that nigga. Like, when it come to working, I want to work. I built a studio in my house so I can mix myself.
Okay.
So I don't have to go to the studio. That type of shit, to want to learn that, to actually learn that. It's just not something everybody else. I don't know how many rappers doing it.